I feel very fortunate that I came along at the time that I did, because it was an incredibly challenging time for women, and Rutgers College had been all male until 1972, when they accepted women for the very first time. And I just happened to be a freshman and had the opportunity to attend Rutgers College as the first class of women to go to Rutgers. So, as I said, timing is everything, and that really helped propel my career. Because when you are in a class of firsts, you really are trained on really how to deal with challenges that you face all the time by a lot of professors and administrators, perhaps, who were not interested in having women there because they thought that we would actually decrease the grade point average. Well, we proved them wrong, and actually the grade point average went up. And so for we women who were the first pioneers at Rutgers, it, I think, helped us greatly in our careers. I've been really lucky in having people approach me about possibilities, but I was willing to take the risk, take it on, and let fear not get in my way of accomplishing what I have so far in my career.
Once I was married and had a couple of small kids, I decided to take a break from working. I had thought about that for a while, and it was a difficult choice because I really enjoyed my career, and AT&T was a great company to work for. When I was ready, as my kids got older, I went back into the workforce, and I was very confident in decisions that I made. And I think some women feel that making that decision, they would have to explain that time or that gap in their work experience. I never felt that. I never felt an explanation was needed. I was very comfortable in that decision, and it never really came up. So I think, you know, an outcome from that for women, younger women, is that you just have to make the choices that are right for you and be confident in those choices, but always continue to learn in any way that you're, either additional education or volunteer work if you're taking a break, but always feel comfortable in the decisions that you're making.
I think a lot of times I was a scientist in the midst of a bunch of engineers, and in a way that always made me feel like I stood out for that, and I didn't think about a lot of the other pieces of it, but it was definitely a challenge being the only woman in the room very often. The skills that I developed in my science degree for analyzing data, collecting data, trying to figure out the story that it told, simplifying whatever that message was in writing have served me very well throughout my career. So now I'm the Chief Member Value Officer at NJBIA, and I know that those skills for problem solving and evaluating information and communicating them clearly are some of the reasons I'm successful today.
You know, every one of us brings something different to the table, and that's why it's so important in a group setting, especially when you're doing problem solving or planning, that you allow every person around that table to input to the situation, because every single one of us brings a different trait and a different way of exhibiting our skills to the table, and that's important.